Hi, this is Sophia from Law Info. Law of Tort. Define tort. What are the essential elements in the action for the tortious liability? Meaning of tort. The word tort is derived from the Latin term tortur, means to twist, and implies conduct which is twisted or tortious. If correspond to the English word wrong or to the Roman delight. Definition of tort. In the words of the Salmon, tort can be defined as a civil wrong, independent of a contract, for which the remedy is an action for the damages. In the view of the Ratanlal, it can also be defined as, it is an act or omission which is prejudicially affect a person in some legal private right. There is an exception in which we must notice that the infliction of all civil injury is not tort. A civil injury in which an action will not lies in not a tort. There is an exception in which we must note that the infliction of the all civil injury is not a tort. A civil injury is in which an action will not lies is not a tort. Tort can be also defined as tortious liability arising breach of duty primarily fixed by the law towards the people generally and for which remedy in action for the liquidated damages. Essential of tort. The following are the essential of tort. Number one, there must be a civil wrong. There must be an infringement of right in rem, right fixed by the law. Remedy. Number one, civil wrong. A tort is a civil wrong, as opposed to the crime on one hand and breach of contract or breach of trust on the other. A breach of contract and breach of trust are the civil wrong, but they also are not tort in tersum, as remedies of efforts for such breach are governed by the statutes, whereas the remedies given for the tort owe their origin to the common law. Number two, infringement of right in rem. A tort is an infringement element of right in rem and not of right in personam. The right in rem is a right vested in some determinate person, either personally or as a member of a community, and available against the world at large. Thus, one's right is not a defamed or assaulted etc. A right available against the whole world. Such rights are knights in rem. The very opposite of right in rem is a right in personam. A right in personam is a right available only against some determinate person or body, and in which the community at the large has no concern. For example, A agrees to sell his house to B for a certain sum. A does not carry out the contract. B will be thereupon have a right to sue for a damage for breach of contract. Where mutual rights of A, B against one another are created, their mutual private agreement. These rights are personal to both of them. Outsiders are not concerned with them. Such rights are therefore called right in personam. For example, personal right as opposed to the general rights. Right fixed by the law. The right which is infringed must be a right which is fixed by the law, independently of the consent of the parties. The right which is fixed by the law is called the legal right and can be defined as legal right is an interest which is recognized and enforced by the law. Remedy. There must be a remedy for the infringement of the right and civil wrong in the form of the compensation. Compensation can be two forms, as explained in the figure that is I show you. Damages or compensation. Damages must be liquidated, but some damages must not be liquidated. In elastic sum of money, there must be a elastic sum of money. Constituent element of the tort. A wrongful act by the defendant. An act is wrongful if it invades three private rights of person. Words, his right to go, reputation, property, and his right of bodily safety and freedom. Legal remedy. The second ingredient of the tort is that such wrongful act should give rise to the legal remedy in shape of the suit damages, legal damages for the plaintiff. Damages in common language means the physical effect of the defendant act. Every invasion of the person, legal right, or unauthorized interference with his property imports legal damages. In essential elements of tort, wrongful act committed by a defendant. In order to make a person for the tort, he must have done an act which he has not expected to do, or he must have omitted to do something which he has supposed to do. Wrongful act is an act which is contrary to the provision of the law, thereby causing injury to the legal rights of another. For example, he commits the act of trespass, is detained, another person is liable to false imprisonment. Similarly, when there is a legal duty to do some act and person fails to perform that duty, he can be made liable for such omission. The wrongful act or wrongful omission must be recognized by law. Therefore, a mere social and moral wrong is not enforceable. For example, if somebody fails to help a starving man or save a drowning child, is only a moral wrong, hence not liable. Cases. Number 1, Glasgow Cronery versus Taylor, 1992. In this case, a corporation fails to put a proper fencing to keep the children away from the poisonous tree, and child plucks and eat the fruit or chestnut, the poisonous tree, and dies. The corporation be liable for such omission. Number 2, General Cleaning Corporation Limited versus Christmas, 1953. In this case, employer fails to provide a safety belt for the safe system of work, liable to consequence of such omission. Legal damage, infringement of legal right. A plaintiff has proved that there has been a legal damage caused to him. It is nothing but the injury to the legal rights of the plaintiff. Thus, the plaintiff has to prove that there was a legal wrongful act or omission on the part of the defendant, causing thereby breach of legal duty or violation of legal rights of the plaintiff vested in him and recognized by law. Therefore, there can be no action under the law of the tort unless there has been violation of the legal rights of plaintiff. Hence, violation of legal right is actionable. It is immaterial whether a plaintiff suffered to any loss in term of the money or not. This provision expressed by the maxim injurious in demno means injury to the legal right of a plaintiff caused by the defendant without any loss in term of the money to the plaintiff. Since what is the actionable in the violation of legal right? It therefore follows that when there is no violation of legal right, no action can be lodged to the court of law, even though defendant act has caused some loss, harm, damages to plaintiff. Classification of tort. Difference between tort and breach of contract. The law of tort in India. Categories of wrongs. Some important definition of tort. Volentia non fit injuria, injuria sine damna, law of limitation. Thank you.